welcome to this video. In this video, we're going to look at RookGNS version 4 and its new features. And for those who are not familiar with RookGNS, RookGNS is a Blender add-on for rigging and animating Genesis figure from Daz here in Blender. And currently in my scene, I have this character, which was originally a Genesis 8 female from Daz Studio. And I have the character fully rigged with the rigging buttons here, ready for animation. Okay, this character here is a golfer, and presently she's on a golf course. So the idea is to have her drive into the scene in this golf cart, and then she gets down, walk towards the back of the golf cart to pick up her club. But in order not to make the video too long, I'm only going to animate the part where she gets out of the cart while showing you the new features in RookGNS 4. So now I'll start by positioning this character around the driver's seat of the golf cart. I'll press 7 on the numpad to go to top view. And this is just to make sure I only move the character's rig along the X and Y axis so I don't mess with the rig's Z axis translation. Now I'll line the character up with the driver's seat. I will also rotate it to match the direction of the cart. Let's see what that looks like. Okay, I think I'll notch this forward a little. Alright, now we have the character positioned at the driver's seat. Now to animate the character, I will collapse this tab and then expand the Animixer tab. So the first thing you'll notice is the new layout. The buttons in the Animixer tab are now categorized into these different sections, which include import, actions, adjustment, and kinematics. Now to bring in the animation, we are of course going to use the import section. So here we can import animations from Mixamo, Daz, Rococo, and ActorCore. Now to bring in the Mixamo animation, I'll go to Get and select Get Mixamo. This opens up my browser on a different screen, so let me drag that into view and maximize the window. Alright, so here we have an export preview character, which is important for keeping the animation compatible with RookGNS. If your preview character isn't set to export, you can change it here in the Characters tab. Alright, now let's search for car-related animation, so I'll just search car. The first result here is the exiting car animation, which is what I need. I'll select it to apply that to the preview character. Now I'll just go ahead and download that. Here I'll set the skin option to without skin. Change the frame rate to 24. And then click download. Now let's return to Blender. With the animation downloaded, I'll go to the import motion section. Select Mixamo. And then import the FBX file we just downloaded. Click import Mixamo. Okay, the animation always loads into the scene right at the world center. Now to attach it to our character, with the rig as the active selection, I'll simply click the bind button. You'll now see the animation is applied to the character, but you'll notice the character is exiting the cart on the wrong side. So to fix that, I'll expand the adjustments tab and then click this mirror button. Now we shall have the character exit on the correct side. Now let's look at some new features that were added to RookGNS 4. Here in the adjust bone section, already we can adjust the angles of any of these bones. For example, with the head bone selected, I can tilt the head up and down. Let's zoom in a bit closer. So now you can see we can tilt the angle of the head by moving the mouse up or down. And we can also click the amplify button to exaggerate the motion of the selected bone. Now here's what's new. For bones that have left and right side, like the arm upper here, you'll see we now have R and L toggles. These allow you to adjust only one side at a time without affecting the other. Let's see how this works on the arm. Now when I click the tilt button, we see both the left and right side are being tilted. Now if I want to adjust just this right side, I can then disable L here, which stands for left. Now when I click the tilt button and move the mouse, you can see it affects only the right side. And the same goes for the other side as well. Okay, the next new feature is also in the adjustment tab, and is this selection only toggle. This is tied to the restore button below it. So ordinarily, when you adjust a bone and then click the restore button, it resets the animation for the selected bone back to its original pose. So that's what happens when you have the toggle enabled. Now to see what disabling the toggle does, let's first tilt some of the bones. I'll start with the head. Tilt that on the x-axis. Remember, we can choose what axis to tilt the bone here. Okay, now I'll select the neck, tilt that on the z-axis, select the shoulder, tilt that up, Again, I'll select the upper arm and tilt that on the y-axis. Now, with all those bones adjusted, when I click on the restore button, with the selection only toggle enabled, it only resets the current selection, which is the arm upper. Now, with the selection only disabled, when I click the restore button, you can see it restores all adjustments that was made, and that makes it easier to revert multiple changes at once. Another powerful new feature is this frame section, where we have this current toggle button. So before I show you what this does, let me quickly make adjustments to the head. So now with the current toggle button disabled, when I tilt the angle of the head like this, the tilt will apply across the whole animation. When I play the animation, you can see that the adjustment is maintained all through the length of the animation. Now let's first restore the adjustment on the head, then go to say frame 45. Now with the current toggle option enabled, tilting the head upward like this would only affect the current frame, which is frame 45. Down here on the panel, we have the before blend frames and the after blend frames. This field simply allows us to control how many frames before and after the current frame should blend in or out of the adjustment. Alright, this means since the current frame is 45 and I have the before and after blend frames set to 3, it will transition into the adjustment from frame 42 to 45 and then transition back to the original animation from frame 45 to 48, blending the adjustment in and out. Now, as I move the playhead using the arrow keys, you can actually see the head animation transitioning into and out of the adjustment, and playing the animation, you should see how smooth the transition looks. Now, let's go ahead and reset the adjustment. So next we have the specify option, which is right beside the current toggle. When I enable it, you'll see these frame fields appear where we can specify a start frame and an end frame. So unlike the current option, which applies adjustment just one frame, the specify option lets us choose a frame range where we want our adjustments to be applied. Let me take the playhead to around frame 15 so I can explain these buttons in the frames field better. This first button set the start frame to frame 1, which is usually where the animation begins. And this second button with the eyedropper icon inputs the current frame into the start frame. So since we are on frame 15, clicking the eyedropper will set the start to 15. Alright, so now say we want the adjustment to be applied only from frame 15 to around frame 50. With the current frame on 50, we can simply click on the second eyedropper to set that as the end frame. So that means any adjustment we make will only be applied from frame 15 to frame 50. We've already looked at the blend frames earlier, so what I will do here is just set both to 10. One thing you should keep in mind when using the specify option is to make sure your timeline cursor stays within the specified frames. If you move the cursor outside this range, like on frame 55, any adjustments made will not be visible because it's outside the specified frames. However, when we move the playhead back within the frame range, say frame 38, tilting the head will now show the adjustment. So let's go ahead and tilt the head up like this. Now we have the adjustment only applied from frame 15 to frame 50. When we go to the first frame, you can see the head doesn't have the adjustment. However, when I press play, you'll see the transition begins around frame 15 and then it reverts back to the original after frame 50. Alright, I should point out that the specify and the current option also works with the position and the rotate buttons. Also, we now have this new restore position button. As the name suggests, it simply restores the position back to its original animation after any adjustment is made. Now, the rotate button here has seen some improvements compared to the previous versions. In previous version, we could only use it before baking the animation. So since the animation is not baked yet, clicking the rotate button still works as expected. Now let's jump to the last frame where the rig is far from its origin. Now when I click the rotate button and move the mouse, you'll notice it rotates from the rig's origin. But when I enable the pin option, it rotates from the character's current position instead. What is new now is that we can still use the rotate button even after baking the animation, something that wasn't possible in the previous version. So let's go ahead and bake the animation by clicking the bake animation button, then click OK. As you can see, the rotate button is still available even after baking. Now let's go to the last frame where the character is away from the origin. I'll disable the current toggle option. Now when I click the rotate button, the character should rotate around the origin. We have this weird rotation happening. It is probably because the rig was rotated earlier when aligning it with the cart. So let's try clearing the rotation by going to Object, Clear, select Rotation. Now you can see the character rotates correctly. Now when I return to the first frame, the character is no longer aligned with the cart. This is where the rotate button comes in handy. So we can just click it and then match the character to the cart. I will advise you to refrain from rotating the rig manually to avoid issues when using the rotate button. Alright, so those are the new features added to the adjustments section. We also have new features added to the kinematics section, previously called the FKIK tab. These include tools that makes combining different animations a lot easier. But we'll dive into that in a separate video so this one doesn't get too long. So make sure you are subscribed to the channel. And if you haven't gotten your copy of RigGNS yet, you can grab it through the Gumroad link in the description. Don't forget to like the video if you found it helpful, and also feel free to drop your thoughts in the comments. Your feedback is what keeps RigGNS getting better. Thank you for watching. Till next time.